is such a rough thing. Yeah.
Now's the time to roll the barrels. All the game's on. Here, da 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 da.
This is where the magic happens.
Wow. And all the couples, they form a ring. For miles around, you hear bells ring, 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 ring.
I just think it's just a love-in, and I love this man, so I have to say it publicly, and I think most of you do as well. I'd say all of you. And it's an honor to be able to acknowledge this extraordinary award that he's received. I mean, this is no mean feat.
Oh, good.
And so I've asked Barbara to say a few words initially. We'll have a few people presenting. She'll talk a little about the Guggenheim and what it means and why it matters. Barbara Bianco.
Thank you. And also, let me say first, this talk about taking a village.
This was an extraordinary village behind the scenes. There were phone calls, there were emails, there was negotiation, there was who was doing what when, and it was just a joy, really, to be part of and to be kind of pulling the strings. So Barbara was in charge of, took it on herself to be in charge of graphics and design, and you'll see why. And then we'll discuss the other credits as we move along.
We've got a list, so yeah, settle in.
We're checking it on the list.
Anyways, this is the Guggenheim. I just wanted to say, many of us know, others don't, but to remind us about what the Guggenheim is and why it matters so much, what makes it such a significant award. So it's a wonderful award, and it's not easy to get. Okay? A Guggenheim Fellowship, it buys time, 6 months to 1 year, for artists and scholars to start a project, finish a project, or head off in a new direction. The only thing the foundation wants, what the foundation privileges, are projects that advance knowledge and creativity. Now, Simon Guggenheim was a senator from Colorado. He and his wife created the fellowship. They established it in 1925 to honor their firstborn son, John, who died just as he was entering college. He died from an ear infection. So they created the foundation and the fellowship to honor him. The competition for a Guggenheim is really stiff. And one of the kind of geeky foundation measures we use to get that across is something called the ratio of awards to applications. So for 2016, Manny's year, was roughly 1 to 17. 1 out of 17 applications got the award. And as you know, with the Guggenheim, newbies need not apply. The Guggenheim is intended for advanced professionals with a record of exceptional work behind them. And Manny Kirchheimer fits the bill here. He's an independent filmmaker with a really keen sense of people and place. And he has a really deft hand at showing how people in different walks of life go about their daily work. You've perhaps seen docking the ocean liner, sorting through cans and garbage for collectibles, printmakers going about their craft in their studios, and just graffiti artists just a range of subjects that he's worked on. Now, on the foundation website, you can find a really lovely short biographical sketch about Manny and his work. It walks you through some of the critical mileposts in his career, beginning with coursework in film production at City College and employment, first jobs, in the New York film industry, and that goes back to 1952. So if you haven't had a chance to log on to the website, I urge you to do that. It's just a lovely introduction, and there is a link to trailers for 9 of Manny's films that are on Vimeo to get a quick little overview. The foundation website also talks about the history of the awards and makes it clear that you have to jump through a lot of hoops to get one. But the one thing you will not find on the website is an icon for a shopping cart. And that's because there is no official Guggenheim gear.
No t-shirt, no swag.
You can't get the sweatshirt. Right. You can't get the paperweight. You can't get the ball cap. So, in keeping with It Takes a Village, we thought unofficial Guggenheim gear might be the way to go. Now, I enlisted Sharon Lewis, who's just a lovely graphic designer, and she came up with fun gear for Manny.
Oh. A button. It says, Manfred Kirschheim, a Guggenheim guy.
it's the unofficial badge.
We have the poster to match it.
Very nice.
We have the poster to match it for those without their glasses. Moving along, our longtime friend Edie Cohen, who Gloria and I met, worked with, these many years ago, has contributed her literary talent to the event.
Some of the many,
yes.
Our dear friend Manny, in mid-career, has given us all good reason to cheer. We know him as teacher and mentor and friend. The roles that he plays we could list without end. But he loves best to apply his work ethic strong, to observe and take note, and then take us along. Filming and editing since way back when, he's produced quite a bit and is at it again. Each film has offered a new perspective to make us pause and be reflective. Not every film can get a mention, but here are some that drew wide attention. Spray Masters taught the world to see a strange new beauty in NYC. Then Stations of the Elevated caused graffitiosos to be elated. A Look at Buildings That Grew Very Tall argued that Louis Sullivan said it all. When Political Life Calls for Revolution, art, says Manny, is the solution. And now we look for new ad banners to herald the coming of a film called Canners. 1 minute, next page.
Get on with it. Come on.
The hook. Throughout it all, his family has stood watching dreams transform into something good. By his side, his loving muse of Gloria, steadfast and enduring, like Queen Victoria. His sons, Gabe and Daniel, and all those they love, offer support, but never a shove. Generous guidance he gives to his friends. Read Anthony Trollope, The Joy Never Ends. Eschewing meat is this wise vegetarian. He's Piscean, but we could believe he's Aquarian. In some we are blessed, we all are blessed to know this Manny. And now the world says it's so. So beloved is our Manny Guggenheimer. He is now a 2016 Guggenheimer.
I think what I find extraordinary about Manny and his work is that he has just kept at it, regardless of the world's view, and because he believed it. And he's taught me to see things I see but didn't really look at, like the canners. And even graffiti. I mean, nobody wanted to look at graffiti. It was an outrage. It was a blight on the city. And now, you know, the 30-somethings have discovered it as original art, which it was, and a huge expression, a creative expression. Many of those artists, which he then featured in Spraymasters 30 years later, 30, 40, have gone on to careers in art with major exhibitions in world-renowned museums. And what I love is that it's now being recognized. And as Manny said once, he said, you know, people who get this recognition are usually dead. So I'm so glad to be alive, to be hearing this. And I'm glad too. So with that, Nellie has something to say.
What I want to say first is I have an urge to tell you about my long friendship with Manfred Guggenheimer, Guggenheim Fellow, and Gloria Guggenheimer, future Guggenheim Fellow. When I was a shy and frightened 22-year-old, just starting to put my toe into the ocean of this frightening scene in New York City, Manny and Gloria became my friends. They found me my first job with dear Panina, who is sitting over there. They put me in touch with a therapist. When my life fell apart, they were there for me, always. And when my life began to blossom again, they were there for me. And they always will be. And I'll always be there for them. But the story I really am here to present is not that one. It's a story about how a bunch of us got together, put our heads together, and thought, what do Manny and Gloria need at this point? And what we decided was they need more fun. They need to have some fun.
That's right.
So everybody who wanted to just tossed in a little money into a hat, and we came up with something which is called the Fun Fund.
Okay.
It's in here.
Oh.
Okay? So you're supposed to use it for anything that you would like. My preference would be travel, because Charlie and I love to travel with you, but you know, really, it's at your own discretion.
I'm for travel. I like travel. Travel is fun. Can I open
you
this, Gloria?
You may open it.
Guggenheim Fellow.
That's
the most important part.
That was
the fun.
Oh, my God.
Fun.
Oh, come on.
To
Manny and Gloria, with congratulations and very much love from all of us lucky enough to know you both. To be used for next travel plans or anything else that strikes your fancy. And then a list of names.
You don't have to list the names.
But you can read the credits.
I thank the names. Congratulations and love, Peter. Love and kisses, Barbara. Mazel tov and love.
This could go on a while.
Yeah, really. But you can read the credits.
Okay, I won't read it all.
You can read the credits on the back.
Oh, my God. But you know, it's $1,800.
Better have some
lunch.
That'll be fun.
Viking River.
It means we're going to travel in the spring. Well, let me say a word or two. I'm very honored by this.
Oops. You really don't want that check.
Oh, yeah.
Check.
I don't, you know.
Give it to Gloria.
Give it to Gloria.
I'm very honored, and I don't want to keep you people from drinking. And I'm particularly honored by Jamie, who insisted on this, and you know, she's our dear friend, and so is Edie and Barbara and Nellie, among all of you. You're all my dear friends. So, thank you very much, and let the
fun begins.
Right.
We have one more presenter, after which we will offer the official toast.
Oh, so I have to thank you also.
Yes. There's a list of credits on the back. I would like them scrolling, but I couldn't figure out the technology.
When Jamie first asked if I might write something about Manny, I thought, since I'm keen on poetry, to find the right metaphor for the dear guy who never missed one chance to visit my Bill as he bounced from hospital to rehab. It was Manny's visit we waited for before calling the last cab. Manny's films have moved me so that I could hardly contain feelings. In We Were So Beloved, the first film I saw, I remember his father's interview asking him, if he were a German then, would he have hidden Jews? I was struck by the courage to ask his father that question, knowing the answer would defy courageous expectations. In his film, we see everything poignantly, the American skyscraper, the canners, the spray masters, claw, discovery in a painting, bridge high. Sublime visions are cut wonderfully, one into another. Poetry on film, deeper than one could speak. But he's out there too, Manny, with chosen words. I remember his strong handshake and smiling introduction to a canner when he then opens up to him. The claw that opens like a flower, crumbling buildings like cake. It is thrilling to have one's eyes opened to see things one never noticed or so well. Visions, words, and music put together by a man who sees, who listens, thinks, and understands. So, what is the metaphor for Manny? A diamond. Not in the rough, though. He's the real thing. Sharp, strong, many-faceted, and shining. He's our treasure.
To our Guggenheim guy.
Great.
Cheers. Not as much.